Good morning, everybody. Let's all gather around the altar and we'll pray for these names on the prayer cloth and in the prayer box. We need to have a board meeting immediately following service this morning. And if you would stand, turn your hymn books to 344. Brother Gary Eberts, could you say a prayer this morning? The best morning service.
Father, we come this morning. Thank you, Father, for keeping us safe for tonight. Thank you for us in the school hour, Lord. We just pray, Father. If the need or he's needed, we pray, Father, get them to be proud, Lord, keep us safe. We ask the Lord, if anyone lost here this morning, we pray something seven times, Lord, we need you. We just pray for strength and grace and all things, Father, thank you for asking these precious things. Amen.
Amen.
Pour our part of the family.
Brother Larry, you want to come up and pick up the offering?
Bless you.
Dear Lord, because of this time, let's give you, just want to give you thanks, Lord, for this beautiful day that you give us, for the opportunity to come out to your house this morning, Lord. As we follow now, let this offer, just basically, using the truth, how to live with thy kingdom. Praise those that have to give, Lord, bless those that have not. These things we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. Turn with us now to 672. Okay. Just remember this request. Anybody else?
Johnny, can continue to remember us or is that?
Okay. Just remember this.
Remember me in the lost of my family.
Okay. Remember this request.
The loss of my family and that for the help.
Okay. Just remember these ones.
Remember Cheryl and I and our children, Johnny. Remember all those that are battling cancer. Okay. Combs and Bob Rice, continue to remember him. And remember Dave and Pirelli's prayer request.
Yes. Remember all these requests.
Remember me and my family.
Okay. Okay.
I have another
Okay.
Johnny, remember the lost in our family, and I still remember the flood victims, and Dale Barton. Still remember him.
Remember all these. We got all the flood victims down in Louisiana too now. All the people out in California who's lost their homes and stuff. Fires going on out there. Remember all these.
John, remember Jerry and Jeremy for their salvation. They'll be coming home this next weekend, so we're trying to remember.
Okay. Remember these.
I have special ones, but...
John, you remember me and my family, and I remember the kids, the ones that's in school, the ones that's in college, or that, you know, pray for their souls.
Remember these requests.
Remember three grandchildren who've been in the prayer for. I ask if you continue to pray for me and pray for our youth program. I'll be going out again Monday morning to work on our youth, building our youth staff in the car bearer position. So pray for me.
Just remember this. Okay. Anybody else?
Pray for this great nation we live in. Lost in my dad's family too.
Jamie, how's your cousin Aaron?
He's doing physical therapy at the hospital. They're talking about moving into a rehab. Haven't done yet. His vitals are good, still not eating like he should. Talk about maybe putting the feeding tube back in on him on that. Still in a lot of pain. Continue to pray for him. Thank God he brought him to where he is.
Amen.
Yeah. Still got a long way to go.
Unspoken request, uplifting hands. Turn with us now to 670.
Yeah.
we have any more prayer requests?
Jamie, you want to lead us off?
Let's all pray. Father, we just thank you for your mercy and for your grace, God. We thank you for the hope we have in you, Lord. Father, we thank you, oh God, in you that we live, we need, we have a need. We ask this morning, God, that you can meet every need, Lord Jesus. All these requests have been given, Lord. The spoken, the unspoken, God, as we lift them up and exalt them today, Father. We know, Lord God, that your will be done, Lord Jesus. Move among us. Heal our sick today, God. We just save our lost people, Lord God. Revive us again and stir our hearts, Lord Jesus. Bless our service this morning. We come into each service, every song, every testimony, God, would you bless the message that goes out. Be food for our soul, Lord Jesus, God. Thank you for all that you've done, God. Thank you for all that you're going to do. Help us, God, to go out in the light of life to them that are perishing today. God, would you comfort them, bring you to be born, build the church upon the name of Jesus Christ, we pray, Father, in Jesus' loving name.
They'd be a soul in the house this morning, Lord, but then as you all pray, they don't believe that way. Jesus' name, have your way in our souls.
Amen.
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 This time the choir is going to bless us with a couple songs.
54.
Just lift our
commands. Anybody got testimony for us this morning?
Yeah, Johnny, I was staying Sunday night. I was scheduled to work, so I was really hoping I could be here. And I was able to talk to him. I prayed to God that he would take care of him. I talked to him. I told him, you know, I'm willing to work for you guys. I am willing to work, you know, every day. But, you know, Sunday, the day I want to be at church, pray to God he worked it out. I'll be here tonight.
Amen.
And not even just that, but my hours weren't just cut. I was actually able to work a shift, so I still got, in a sense, close to the hours that I would have gotten. So God really blessed me. You know, double that.
Amen.
Donnie, I want to thank the Lord for giving me the opportunity to hear down God bless you. Right, tonight, listen to all of God's songs. And I had relation there, and I always just think back when I see these people. My granddad sitting out there on that front porch with his Bible, teaching these grandkids, these kids, you know. Some of us listened, some of us didn't. Mm-hmm. But you know, someday there's going to be a great day coming, and we're all going to be together. And I know the Lord has touched a lot of people's hearts down there. And there are very few people that was there in that park. But I'll tell you what, when we all see Jesus, Brother Jamie, that whole riverside is going to be full of people worshiping the Lord and thanking the Lord for everything that he's done. And I just praise him today. I give him all the praise and all the glory for everything that he's done in my life. And I'll tell you what, he blesses me every day.
Amen.
And he blessed me down there. Just my cousin's singing these gospel songs. And I know, like I said, someday, I know we're all going to be together, and we're all going to sing these songs.
That's right.
Can't sing very good, but we're all going to sing for the Lord.
Amen.
And I thank him today, and I just want to bless him every day. Thank you.
Amen. Let's hear another one. That was a good one. Anybody got a song for us this morning?
Still
place
to be people and what
they're missing.
Amen.
Amen. Hey, John, I know how I used to talk about how progress and how God's really, you know, letting me move and go forward. And today, this might be kind of funny, but yesterday I had looked, you know, I got paid stuff. I looked at the account statement, how you got bills going out. I saw, you know, because it's a recurring theme, what I need, you know, to further this. And I saw it, and I was like, yeah, you know, it was just great. You're looking at it like, yeah, that's right, getting charged in. It's just, I have faith in it. And now I'm seeing it. It's far from finished, but I'm starting to see physical evidence, you know what I mean? Like, I'm starting to see a physical manifestation of the faith that I had before. And it's just a blessing to actually see this come. You know, it's one thing when you believe, but when you start to see, it's awesome.
Yes.
You look at it, and it's just like, usually you wouldn't really be happy to see a bill, but when I see that one, I am happy.
Yeah.
I am happy to see that bill, but I'm still kind of like, yeah, that's right. You know, it's just awesome to see God moving.
Uh-huh. Amen. Somebody else got a testimony?
Well, on this opportunity, Joe, we just thought I'd thank him for what he brought me out of, where he put me.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of what friends that I run with, you know, a lot of them didn't change their way. Not very many of them left nowadays.
That's right.
Back in the day, there was, you know, they give a lot of drugs and alcohol and probably never left them. I just prayed for reaching down there and set me up on a rock this morning.
Amen. Thank you. Somebody else?
That's right. And then you're praying for my child. And I'm praying for your brothers once I love you all.
Amen. Got a testimony.
John said, I love the Lord and I saw him while I saved. You know, I think of this. But every day, things I go through, a lot of self-inflicted stuff I do, but you know, the Lord's always been there for me.
Amen.
It's amazing that he cares for even the littlest things that happens, you know, even our pets and things like that. You know, he's there all the time. And I praise him. I said, I was listening to tape that Patrick gave me of that. I can't never, that's my trouble. I can't remember names and stuff. But it's the message the man preached, I said, it just amazed me to be that bold, you know, when he's talking about he was even in a restroom and the Lord said, you know, you talk about talking and praising me, why not now?
Amen.
And in front of everybody, he said, Lord, don't let you do this. And the Lord said, okay. But he did. And I thought, you know, we say, do we? And I keep praying that the Lord will give me that boldness and the strength and the grace to do the things that pleases him.
Amen. Amen.
A good place to be this morning.
Yes, it has been. Been a wonderful place. Anybody else?
Those words, oh, what a Savior.
Mm-hmm.
He's with us. Brother carries it all the time. He knows about each and every one of us. He knows our name. I'm so glad I know that Savior.
Amen. Lord, just been so good to me. I just want to praise Him every day for it, every minute, about how good He's been good to me over the past years. Saved my soul. Was 49 years old, you know. But I feel like He really cares for me. Amen. Anybody else got a testimony or a song? If we're all done, stand while we call the pastor.
Second Kings chapter 19. Second Kings chapter 19 this morning. Second Kings chapter 19, verse 14 says, and Hezekiah received the letter of the hand of the messengers and read it. And Hezekiah went up into the house of the Lord and spread it before the Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord Jesus, for your mercy, for your grace. I thank you, God, for the hope that we have in you. I pray today, Lord Jesus, God, as we look into your word for a few minutes, hide us all behind the very cross of Calvary. Lord, we love you. We praise you, Lord, for the Savior that you are. I ask today, Father, Lord God, just fill this house with your Spirit. Lord, if there's one among us that's backslidden, God, would you draw them home? One that's lost and undone, would you save? One that's erring, would you admonish, Father, Lord? One that's weak, would you strengthen, we pray, God, in Jesus' name. And amen. You may be seated this morning. I'd like to preach for just a few minutes. If it be the will of the Lord, I'd like to preach on this. Amen. Give it to the Lord. Give it to the Lord. In this chapter, one of my favorite stories in the Bible is this one. As we come and begin to look at it this morning, as we go back earlier in verse 3, the statement is made by Hezekiah, go down to the house of Isaiah the prophet, and you know, you give him a copy of the letter, and this is what you tell him. Said, thus saith Hezekiah, this is a day of trouble and of rebuke and of blasphemy. And talks about how weak that they are. We find here that the children of Israel had, they went through cycles and ups and downs. And after Solomon's death, they went through a lot of different kings. We know that the kingdoms were split to the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. And they all went through kings that were good and kings that were bad. But Hezekiah, turns out, is one of the good. One of the first things that Hezekiah did as he became king, as when he came in, he wiped out all idolatry. Like our class told us to this morning, our Sunday school lesson. He cut down every grove. He destroyed the prophets. Amen. He got rid of all the worship of idols in the land. Hezekiah began to live a good life and had a good reign. And all of a sudden, the Syrians, amen, listen, they came up against him, and they set a watch round about the wall, and they began to blaspheme the name of God. And they said, you know, we came up against this nation, and their gods didn't deliver them. We went over against this nation over here, and their God didn't deliver them. And said, what makes you think that the God of Israel is going to be any different than the God of all the nations around us? And I want you to know there's something this morning. Amen. Listen, that the God that you and I serve, amen, is the God. He is the true. He is the only. He is the living God. He's the creator of the heavens and the earth. He's hung the sun, the moon, and the stars in place. And no doubt there's times in our life that we just like Israel here. We have enemies that come up against us, amen. And they come in and they act like they're going to run over us. And it looked like all the people, listen, I'm talking about a great army that was outside the wall. The city was surrounded. Amen. Everybody's like, what in the world are we going to do? But thank God for a man of God that knew where to go. Amen. Hezekiah knew, amen, listen, that his hope wasn't in Isaiah. Hezekiah knew that his hope, amen, listen, wasn't in his army. It wasn't in the money that he had in his down in the bank or wherever it was at in the treasure house. But he knew where to turn to. My friend, can I tell you today? David made this statement. He said, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Hezekiah got the letter. Amen. Listen, these scribes were on the wall. They were writing it down. Amen. This is what they said. Should come. If you'll come out, amen, listen and follow and worship and serve us and be our servants, we'll let you live. But this is what we're going to do. We're going to make you drink your own urine. We're going to make you eat your own bowels. Listen, brother, in other words, it's not going to be good whether you come out or not. We're here to destroy you today. As they come out, amen, Hezekiah read the letter. I want you to know he didn't start counting his soldiers. He didn't start sharpening his sword. Amen. Listen, in his clothes, which meant that he was in great sorrow and great distress. And he went into the house of the Lord and he took that letter. And as he brought that letter in there, amen, listen, he laid it there on the altar. And he began to say, hey God, did you see this? Hey God, did you hear what the enemy's saying? You know what he began to do? He said, wait a minute, God. He said, you're the God that made the sun, the moon, the stars. You're the creator of all the earth. This is your people. This is your land. This is your city. Now, Lord, they've come up. He didn't say they've come up against me. He said, but God, they've come up and blasphemed your name. God, they're out there making fun of you. God, they're trying to destroy your people. I want you to understand something, my friend. The devil doesn't have an axe to grind, amen, listen, against you. He's got an axe to grind against God. And when he comes to try to destroy us and lead us astray and brings false prophets in front of us, him teachers, amen, that want to tell us things that are contrary to the word of God, I want you to realize, brother, it's the devil trying to get at God. Amen, I can't handle the devil. You can't handle the devil. Amen, listen, I realize a couple weeks ago, amen, listen, we run him out, amen, but know this, brother, he knows where the doors are to get back in. We need to be on guard. We need to give it to the Lord. We need to trust him for our deliverance. Amen, listen, in our weakness, God's strength is made perfect. Which one of us, amen, can think that we can take on the devil and win? But I want you to know, if we'll give it to the Lord, whatever our troubles is this morning, if you bring it to God, God and leave it there. Amen. Listen, I'm not talking, amen, listen, about getting down. Amen. Saying, God, here's my problem, and I need you to give it to you. Amen. It's your problem there. God, you're going to have to fix it. Amen. And then you pick that problem back up and say, well, I just don't know what I'm going to do. Amen. Isaiah, or not an Isaiah, but Hezekiah brought that letter in, and he laid it there on the altar. He said, God, this is your problem. You're going to have to fix it. I don't have the strength. I don't have the power. I don't have the ability, amen, to fix it. But God, it's yours. And when Hezekiah was there praying, God sent the message down and said, you go tell Hezekiah, amen, I've heard. I want you to know something, brother. There's nothing the devil ain't said, nothing the devil ain't done to you, amen, this week, amen, that God doesn't already know about. He sees your situation. He knows the heartache that you're going through. He sees the tears that have run down your face. Amen. Listen, he knows the hurt that's in your soul and your heart today. And therefore, brother, amen, the enemy might think that they're great. Amen. But he said, you tell him, I'll put my finger in the nose of that king. I'll lead him back into his own land. Amen. Listen, I'm going to hear, cause him to hear a matter. And he'll go home, and he'll not set foot in this land no more. I want you to realize, brother, amen, the devil may have reign, amen, in the life of the world today, but as a child of God, amen, if we're submitted to God, he doesn't have authority over you, my friend. He's not in charge of your life, amen. He's not able to destroy you. Remember our verse over here now, if God be for us, who can be against us? We need to make up our mind today. This problem's not mine, brother, but it's God. And if we give it to God, I want you to know I don't have any magic formulas. Amen. Listen, to build this church. Amen. It's God's job. I don't have any magic formulas. I don't have any special messages. Amen. Listen, within myself that I can pull out of a drawer. Amen. Listen, to encourage you. But I know a God who can. I can't, amen, win your people, but I know a God who can. Do you realize it's in God today? There was 100, amen, listen, and 85,000 soldiers that surrounded that city. Amen, listen, Hezekiah, as he was there before the face, on his face before the Lord, amen, God gave him the answer. And that very night, brother, God went outside that city and killed 185,000 soldiers. Amen. The king came with a great host and he went home empty-handed. Can I tell you, brother, every time that we think that we're outnumbered, amen, we've got to be like the servant of Elijah and open our eyes. For they that are with us are more than they that are against us, brother. Amen. Listen, they're surrounded. Amen. Listen, around us, the Bible said the angels of the Lord encamp about them that love him and fear him. Listen, there's an unseen host, amen, protecting us. Amen. Listen, the devil would love to destroy you and I, but he can't, because he's defeated. He's already conquered. Therefore, if we'll give it to God, if we'll bring it to God and leave it there, brother, we can get the victory in the name of Jesus today. It's not my name. It's not the name of Puritan Free Will Baptist that makes the devil tremble. Amen. But when you mention the name above every name, the name that God hath highly exalted, the name that every knee should bow, the name that every tongue shall confess. When you confess that name, Jesus, this morning, I want you to realize, brother, it shakes the gates of hell. Amen. Why? Because it's already conquered. Amen. It's already defeated. Why should I fight battles that Christ has already won? Why can't we trust him? Why can't we love him? Why Why can't we just follow him? Why is it? I tell you why. Because we've got too much pride. We think we've got the answer in ourselves. We've got this. We don't need any help. Can I tell you today, brother? I need every day, every hour. I need thee, oh Lord. I need thee. Listen, every song, every testimony, every prayer, every sermon, every lesson that's taught. I need God, brother, in there every day that I face. When I get up to go outside, or man, listen, or just sit down and just turn to the Word of God, I need God. When I get in my car, I need God. As I'm out on my job, I need God. When I lay my head on my pillow, I need God. Amen. Give it to God. Let's trust him and obey him, because there's no other way. Simply trust and obey. Now, had Hezekiah just throw that letter down and said, okay, God, you got it. And now, God, now I'm going to get my sword because I know you got it. You see, that wasn't God's plan. He laid it out there and he waited on God. They that wait upon the Lord, remember, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with the wings of eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I'm telling you, wait the say on the Lord. Can I tell you today, he's my keeper today. Remember, he's my bread when I'm hungry. He's my water when I'm thirsty. He's my shelter in a time of storm. He's my rock in a weary land. He's my captain. Amen. He's my leader. He's my God. He's my Savior. He's my Lord. He's my healer. When my body's afflicted, it's God that heals it today. I realize we got good doctors and we got good nurses. Amen. Listen, but it's God that does the healing today, brother. It's God that leads and guides. Hey, listen, brother. It's time that we wake up, shake ourselves, and trust God this morning. Give it to the Lord. Hezekiah said, Lord, God of Israel, which dwellest between the cherubs. Number one, thou art God. Number two, and thou alone. Number three, of all the kingdoms of the earth, thou hast made heaven and earth. You see, there's people out there that they think that they got where they are because of their hard work. Can I tell you, brother, it's because of God. It's God that sets up a kingdom. It's God that sets up a nation. It's God that will bring it down. Amen? We need to realize where our strength comes from, where our hope comes from. He said, Lord, bow down thine ear and hear, O Lord. Thine eyes see, thine ears hear the words of Sennacherib, which thou hast sent him in to reproach, which he has sent to reproach the living God. Hezekiah didn't take these words against himself. He said, God, he's not cursing me. God, he's cursing you today. Amen. Let's realize today, amen, that God has already won the victory. God has already won the battle. Let's give it to God. Let's trust. Let's obey. Let's pray. Let's sing. Let's shout praises to God. Let's march forward as the men and women of God that we are. Give it to God. What are you going to do with it? Your troubles that you brought with you this morning. What are you going to do with it? You going to take it back home? The sin you carried in here, that burden, that guilt. What are you going to do with it? You going to give it to God? You going to take it back home? Let me tell you what God does to sin. Sinner comes to the Lord, humbles himself before God, falls on their face, says, Lord, be merciful unto me, a sinner. With a humble heart, a true heart, God reaches down in love and mercy, takes that sin and casts it as far as the east is from the west, never to be remembered anymore. That's the God that I serve. That's the God. You don't have to live in the past. You can live in the future. What do you mean, preacher? Brother, I'm not living for today. Amen. I'm working for the Lord for today. But I'm not living for today. Why? Because my home is not here. My retirement plan is not here. My real home, brother, amen, has walls of jasper and gates of pearl. My real home has there's a street that's pure gold. That's the city that I'm going to. I hate going down into a big city. Amen. They changed the exit. They had the exit we normally go off to shut down. Throw me all out of whack. Amen. Listen, just to get in there and park. But can I tell you, amen, listen, I know the way. Amen. To get there, how is it, preacher? What is, how do you get to heaven? Amen. Listen, you follow Jesus. And if you follow him, you've never been lost today. We have trucks. They run up and down our interstates across this nation called courtesy trucks. And their job is to constantly be monitoring the radio on the highways. Someone has difficulty. Someone is lost. I remember one time, me and my brother, first time we ever went up north hunting by ourselves up to Doddridge County, not Doddridge County, but Ritchie County up in that area hunting by ourselves. And we come back down to Charleston there and we forgot which exit. Amen. We couldn't remember how we was going to get home. And finally he got on the radio and began to holler out. You know what that guy did? That guy said, "You just stay right where you're at. I'll be right there." When he got to where we was at, he said, "Follow me." And he led us to the right place. And he said, "You follow this road. You stay this exit, you follow this road and have a good day." Can I tell you, that's the way God does. When we get off track and we don't know where to turn, the Holy Spirit says, "Hey, I'm here to help you. Amen. Follow me." And if we'll follow his leadership and his direction, we can make it home safe. Give it to the Lord. But you know what? If we'd have never asked for help, we drove around Charleston all night. I'm telling you, we done went around a couple times. We didn't know where to go. But I want you to know, you may have got off the track. You may have got off on the wrong road. But the Holy Spirit is here to put you back on the right track this morning. Amen. A God is more willing to help you out, amen, than what you were to ask. He said, "While they're yet speaking, yet will I hear." Brother, God's not slow. He's quick in mercy and quick in love today, brother. He's slow to anger, but he's quick to mercy and love. And if you'll say, "Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, forgive me. Lord, put me back on the right path this morning," I promise you, he'll do just that. Come on, girls, let's get a song. Give it to the Lord. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know where you've been. I don't know what you've done. Amen. I'm not up here today. It's not my job, amen, to point you out, to call you out. My job is to preach you what the Word of God says. And if God, it's the Holy Spirit that draws you, amen, to bring that problem to God. It's the Holy Spirit that says, "Come back home." Amen. Listen, it's the Holy Spirit that says, "Give your heart back to God and follow and serve Him." And if you'll do that today, amen, God's already did the work. If you'll trust Him. As we stand right now, what's your number, girls? 55. Come on. Come on. I know God's spoken to hearts this morning. Come back home, backslider. You got burdens you can't carry. Give it to God this morning. Come on. Come on. Nobody here has a robe of judgment on, brother. I want you to understand we're all sinners saved by grace. Come on, church. God, have mercy this morning, Lord. There's still room at the altar for you. Is your heart right with God? Is there a burden you're carrying today that just seems like the weight of the world is crushing you? He said, "Cast all your cares upon me, for I care for you." Come on. Come on, there's still room. Thank you. out as she plays softly. So one would say, "Preacher, I've got a heavy heart this morning. I need prayer. Would you just hold your hand up, take it down real fast?" But that hand is another. But that hand is another. "Preacher, I've got a heavy heart this morning. I need prayer." One would say, "Preacher, I'm not where I need to be with God. I need prayer. Would you pray for me?" Is there one while we tarry for just a minute? Set hand. Almighty God, as we call on you, holding your precious name. God, I know you saw the hands this morning. God, you know every heart. God, would you allow the Holy Spirit to do its work, Lord? Bring healing, Lord Jesus, where it needs to be today, God. I pray, God, most of all for our people that are lost and undone and backslidden, Lord. Would you help them to see a need in their eye for a Savior? God, help us to be the light, to be that example, Lord, to point him to you, Lord. Not to draw attention to ourselves, but to point him to you, Lord. To show him the way home. And to come to realize that things were better in Father's house. Lord, we know we have a series of meetings scheduled, Lord. Only revival comes through by you, Lord. Brother Barry didn't have any special tricks with Jesus, God, to bring to us, God. But God, it takes a conviction power of God. And I would ask today, God, you would shake Vinton and Jackson and Meigs, Gallia counties. You would shake our state, Lord. Shake our nation with the power of God one more time. With great revival, Lord. We know you can come in any minute, Lord. Our heart's desire, Lord, is to see our nation turn back to you. For we know that all nation, Lord, that means that all people, God, that forget you will be turned into hell. Oh, God, give us a burden, a vision like we've never had. Help us be willing to pay the price, Lord Jesus, to see them saved, or to go the extra mile. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Don't forget choir practice tonight. 5:15, be here at 5:10 so we can get started. The reason that is because the choir is singing next Sunday afternoon in a homecoming down at Buckeye. Looking forward to a good time down there. Brother Junior Preston will be here this coming Wednesday to preach to us. Not this Tuesday, but the following Tuesday is Masters Men and Ladies Aid on the 30th there. Don't forget that, 7 o'clock. Youth group is tomorrow night at 6:30. Need all the help that they can get. Bring kids. Surround them up. Let's reach out to this generation and I don't want the next generation to be like the one we've got now. That's an unchurched generation. We need to tell them the truth and that Jesus saves. You know, our schools, some of them already started. I think Vinton County, or not Vinton County, but Jackson County started. Vinton and Meigs both start back this week. I would like to see what happened in the schools of West Virginia. Here are schools around here where hundreds of young men and women give their heart and lives to God. That's what we need. That's what we need. We need revival among us. Amen. I will say something about the revival. Monday night is youth night at our church. So I have asked Ethan to come and preach to us on Monday night. He's 14. And I believe that would be a good witness to them young people. If God can use a young 14-year-old man to preach, that might encourage some of them. It might encourage some of our youth, right? Amen. To step out and answer the call to what God has in for them. Other than that, I will do the preaching. I'm not going to schedule any special singers. Probably one thing we're going to do. Your brother Barry's coming a long way. So probably what we'll do every night is take up an offering to help Brother Barry. The expenses plus the church will kick in some as well. That way that we can be a blessing to him and not a hindrance, right? Amen. Amen. All right. Don't forget that the board needs to meet for just a few minutes immediately after Sunday school. Don't pray about the service. Come back tonight with a song or a testimony. Amen? Amen. Most of all, come back tonight. All right? All hearts free. All right, let's praise the Lord when we leave here. Praise